from then on, we knew this was the end. Once the American, you know, there was the debarkation. Now, what's the name of D-Day?
The invasion.
The invasion. We knew that was the beginning of the end. So the summer was very hopeful, and we listened very carefully to where they went. So in, I think it was the 24th of August that we had the liberation of Paris. The day before, we were sitting in the park of the school, and the anti-aircraft guns were going, and we had to really watch out for that. But they weren't bombing Paris, but Paris, they were, the Germans were still trying to hit the American planes. We went to bed the night before, and then the next morning we heard that the French troops are coming in. And the Americans let the French come in first. And Sèvres is a town that goes up, and our home had sort of ramparts, a wall, and we were all sitting on the wall, and we saw the French troops coming in, and they were playing the Marseillaise. And the second verse is, Liberté, liberté, chérie. And that was so touching. It was just one, it's like it was yesterday. And then the Americans came in, and that was just pure joy. Everybody jumped, and it was, we knew it was the end of the occupation, and everybody was hopeful. And the next 8 months or till the end of the war, there was such hope. There was such renewal of life. And even afterwards, it was incredible.
Now, at this point, did you have any expectation that you might be reunited with your
parents?
Oh,
absolutely. There was no doubt that we were going to be reunited.
And your friends felt the same way?
Yes. Everybody felt that way. And we went... The end of the war was not till March. I was already in... Till May.
Yes.
I was already in Lyon. And after the end of the war, the lists came back of the survivors. And we went down every 2-3 days to check the new lists. I went down with my friends to the station with pictures. You know, we helped. We gave them water or whatever to drink and food. But mainly we went to show the pictures to, have you seen this? Do you know where you were? And that went on, and then hope became thinner and thinner, but you never gave up. You know, there were rumors that people were still in Russia, and I didn't know that my parents had been deported to Auschwitz. I thought they were in Theresienstadt still. And I actually never found out that my parents died.
To this day?
No, I was in Auschwitz 2.5 years ago. And in Auschwitz, I got a little index card with the date of arrival of my parents in Auschwitz.
Which was what, do you remember?
I think it was November 44. And my brother's, who was September 44. They didn't give me a death certificate, but... And I just looked at it when I saw it, and my husband, who was born in Newark, he didn't... All his family has always been here, but... When he saw me holding that index card, he started crying. He said, that's what's left. To me, it didn't, at that point, I didn't even understand, still didn't understand it.